Hi, I am Dr. Saqib Mansoor, and today I will discuss with you skull foramina and structures passing through them. So, first of all, we will see the internal foramina of the skull. You could see this picture, and this is the cranial cavity, anterior cranial fossa, middle, and the posterior cranial fossa, and the various spottings you can do afterwards on your own, even that has been discussed in detail in my previous lecture. The cranial cavity, you see this is the anterior cranial fossa, contains the foramen cecum and the olfactory foramen and the cerebriform plate. Foramen cecum, it passes through the emissary veins to nasal cavity, and the olfactory foramen, it passes olfactory nerve. You could see this. This is the foramen cecum. This one, let me zoom for you. Spend some time. The topic is very important. You could see this. This is foramen cecum, and this is the, cribriform plate. This is cribriform plate. Follow this hand cursor, and this is the foramen cecum. This is the anterior cranial fossa. And what is in foramina are present in the middle cranial fossa. One is the optic canal. The optic nerve and the ophthalmic artery passes through that. Superior orbital fissure. It passes through the oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve, ophthalmic vein of the trigeminal nerve, abducens nerve, and the ophthalmic veins. Foramen rotundum passes maxillary vein of the trigeminal nerve, and the foramen avalis passes through the mandibular vein of the trigeminal nerve, lesser pterosal nerve, and from foramen spinosum passes the middle meningeal artery. Hiatus for greater pterosal nerve, the greater pterosal nerve, and hiatus for the lesser pterosal nerve lets through the lesser pterosal nerve. And you could see this middle cranial fossa with most of the foramina present in the sphenoid bone. Ross is the mnemonic, foramen rotundum, and avail, and this spinosum. Here you could see this. This is rotundum foramen, and this is a foramen avail, and this is a foramen spinosum, right? And let's see the superior orbital fissure. This is the, you could see our superior orbital fissure, and this is the optic canal. Right, so this is various important foramina present in the middle cranial fossa. So let's move to the posterior cranial fossa. It contains a very big and important fossa, the foramen magnum, and many structures passing through that. And end of the brainstem, or the beginning of the spinal cord, vertebral arteries, spinal roots of the accessory nerves, and the meninges. Right. So the internal acoustic meatus contains the facial nerves, vestibulocochlear, and the labyrinthine artery. And the jugular foramen passes glossopharyngeal nerve, vagus, accessory, and the inferior pterosal sinus and the sigmoid sinus, which forms the internal jugular vein. And the hypoglossal canal lets through the hypoglossal nerve, meningeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. And the condylar canal lets through the mystery vein. And this is, you could see, this is the foramen magnum in the posterior cranial fossa, right? You could see other structures as well. Well, again, we'll zoom. You could see this, right? This is supranear posterior cranial fossa. And this is the, you could see jugular tubercle. This is the cerebellar fossa for cerebellum, and this is groove for transverse sinus, and this is the groove for sigmoid sinus. This is the continuation, contains the internal jugular vein, and this is the very important internal acoustic meatus in the petrous part of the temporal bone for the protection, as this is the thickest and strongest bone of the body, the petrous temporal fissure nerve passing through that, right? These are the important foramen and the posterior cranial fossa. So this was all about the fossa present in the cranial cavity. So let's move on. And the external foramina of the skull, first of all, is the anterior view of the normal frontalis. Here you could see this. This is obvious over here. This is the our supraorbital foramen, and this is the infraorbital foramen, and the third one is the mental foramen, right? This is very important, these three. So first of all, supraorbital foramen leads to the supraorbital nerve and vessels. Infraorbital foramen leads to the infraorbital nerve and vessels. Mental foramen leads to the mental nerve and the vessels. In the lateral view, you could see this again, the zygomaticofacial foramen, right? Here it is present. Follow this arrow. And it leads to the zygomaticofacial nerve. In the superior view is the parietal foramen, which leads to the Meshy veins. Let me show you. This is the superior view. This is the parietal bones, and this is the parietal foramen, right? And now the structures passing through foramen, the inferior view, the norma basalis, right? Most of the structures are also in the foramen are present in the cranial cavity. This would be a repetition. And you see the inferior view, right? This is the inferior view, right? We can spot all the foramen over here. So first of all, is the incisive foramen, nasopalatine nerve, and sphenopalatine vessels pass through that. Greater palatine foramen, greater palatine nerve and vessels pass through that. Then is the lesser palatine foramen and lesser palatine nerves and vessels pass through that. Pterygoid canal leads through the pterygoid nerve and the vessels. Foramen of Weyl, spinosum and lastum present in this view, norma basalis as well, or the inferior view. Carotid canal, inguinal carotid artery in the nerve plexus, foramen magnum, likewise in the cranial cavity, condylar canal, right? The Meshy veins, the hypoglossal canal. I told you it leads to the hypoglossal nerve and the vessels. This is the jugular foramen, three cranial nerves passing through that, 9th, 10th, and 11th. And then stylomastoid foramen for the facial nerve. You could see this here in the various foramina. This is the anterior part of the norma basalis. This is the middle part. And this is the posterior part. You could see this. This is the our occipital condyle, right? And this is a small challenge for you. We'll immediately put it away from this your view. This is the norma basalis structures labeled, and this is a key as well over here. So you have to answer that, right? This is the way with it. This is another view of the cranial cavity, the structures labeled over here, the important one. I thank you very much. So stay tuned, please. I will be coming up with very important other videos too on the head and neck, this series again of the small topics. Like I have even taken the structures passing through the superior orbital fissure, separate small topic, and the structures passing through the foramen magnum, another small topic.